thanks for taking a few minutes to talk to us today. Sri, there's so much talk about what 5G can do for people in their lives. What is the impact of 5G on the transport infrastructure?
First, there is a tremendous amount of interest from customers and customers on 5G. And Nokia just recently announced that we have over 40 5G contracts, public contracts signed. One of the first things customers look at before they design and contemplate deploying 5G is, what does 5G mean for them? Beyond the marketing aspect of being first in the market in delivering 5G, there is a question of what is the business case? What does low latency applications, low latency capability bring to the industry? The first two use cases people talk about is massive broadband. People want, you know, gigabit. People want fixed wireless access potentially in places where fiber is not readily available. In those scenarios, from a transport perspective, it's the lowest cost per bit. And that's automated provisioning of the transport infrastructure to reduce cost, to put the right amount of redundancy in the entire network and reduce cost. But the more interesting and exciting things for the transport is when there are applications that require a certain amount of latency, whether it happens to be less than 5 milliseconds or 10 milliseconds latency. That requires us to come up with flexible edges, ability to bring up a cache, a content deeper into the network, and then potentially collapse it back when the event is done. So your transport infrastructure has to be extremely flexible. The gateways have to be extremely flexible. The ability to automate and bring up a slice as required is extremely critical, right? And part of this also is for our customers, service provider customers, to work and understand the end applications so they can build the right network infrastructure.
Thanks, Sri. That was really interesting. And thanks so much for spending some time with us today.
Sure. Thank you.